Infliximab is a biologic drug used to treat inflammation and autoimmune conditions such as inflammatory bowel disease and rheumatoid arthritis. Unfortunately, 40% of patients who initially achieve remission may experience a loss of response in the first year of therapy. To address this concern, we must look at how the drug is being used and monitored. New research suggests that patients who are receiving proactive monitoring may have a lower risk of treatment failure, surgeries, hospitalizations, and serious reactions during therapy. Proactive monitoring involves individualizing the dose of infliximab for each patient to achieve a target concentration in the blood. Every human is different and responds differently to medication. This can give clinicians a hard time when deciding how to dose infliximab proactively for each patient. Population pharmacokinetics can help. PopPK allows clinicians to individualize doses according to patient characteristics, such as body weight, age, disease status, or immunogenicity, using statistics and large amounts of data from clinical trials. Now, plenty of this information is available for adults, but that's not the case when it comes to children. Drug therapy in children requires special attention because they are very different from adults when it comes to both size and physiological maturity. My research uses a physiologically based approach to translate what we know about PopPK and proactive monitoring in adults to the pediatric population. I use mathematics and computer simulations to represent the two populations according to their anatomy and physiology. Describing our statistical knowledge of drug distribution and elimination in terms of the underlying mechanisms allows us to translate the effects of body weight, age, disease status, and immunogenicity to the pediatric space. By combining principles from PopPK and physiologically based modeling, my research makes another step toward ensuring that clinicians can provide safe and effective dosing recommendations for infliximab in children.